Dear Travis, I have had a crush on you since the first day I saw you. Though I have to admit, at first it was purely physical attraction, over the days, months, and years, I have learned that behind that handsome exterior is a kind, patient, and loving heart. A man who works hard to bring out the best in me. Our love story has been written by the places we have lived, detours we have taken, and people we have met, choices we have made. Today, as we make the choice to spend our life together, I'm grateful to be marrying my crush, my lover, and my best friend. Wherever life may take us, I promise to love and care for you and always cook for you. I will be yours in plenty and in want. I will dream with you, celebrate with you, and walk beside you today and always.
So gorgeous before. I've learned that you can truly know a person's character through tough times. The hardships we went through in Holland showed me exactly who you were, and I knew during that moment in our lives that I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you. I promise to always think of you and your feelings first before mine. I promise to always be there for you, no matter the circumstances. I have truly found my best friend in you, and I will always love you.
It's a good thing you're wearing sunglasses.
You kept it together well.
So as you approach this state of marriage with your own rich heritage behind you, cherish the uniqueness that you offer to each other. Because marriage is about love and joy and peace and patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness between a husband and a wife. And a wife and a husband are each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and critic. So I'm going to ask you first, Travis. These are the words you're going to say to me. I solemnly declare that I do not know of any lawful impediment why I, Travis James, should not be married to Tanya. There you go. And now, Tanya, I solemnly declare that I do not know of any lawful impediment why I, Tanya, may not be joined in matrimony to Travis James. So now you have joined hands, and each of those hands is an extension of yourself. Cherish the touch, for you touch not only your own, but another life. Be ever sensitive to its pulse. Seek always to understand and respect its rhythm. And Travis, I ask you, will you take Tanya to be your wife? Do you commit yourself to her happiness and self-fulfillment as a person? Do you promise to love, honor, and trust her? Will you be by her side in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity? And will you be true and loyal to her for as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do. And now, Tanya, do you take Travis to be your husband? Do you commit yourself to his happiness and self-fulfillment as a person? Do you promise to love, honor, and trust him? Will you be by his side in sickness and in health, in adversity and prosperity? And will you be true and loyal to him for as long as you both shall live? I call on those present to witness that I, Travis James, take you, Tanya, to be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife. Good job. I call on those present to witness.
I call on those present to witness.
That I, Tanya, take you, Travis James, to be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Good job.
That can go back so fast.
Could I have the rings, please? So now you're sitting before me on this book are two beautiful, precious wedding rings. And these wedding rings serve as a symbol of the vows that you have just made to one another. They are an outward and visible sign of all that love that you have for each other. And being one unbroken circle, they symbolize unending love. And these are the words that you're going to say to her as you put this ring on her finger. I give you this ring that you may wear it as a reminder of our vows and my love and commitment to you. And you replace it on her finger. And now you'll take her engagement ring and place that beautiful engagement ring on over the top, thus marrying those two beautiful rings together. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
That you may wear it.
That you may wear it.
As a reminder of our vows.
As a reminder of our vows.
And my love and commitment to you.
And my love and commitment to you.
So now you have both declared, in this company, you have declared that you want to be legally married. You have exchanged your wedding vows to each other, and you have exchanged wedding rings
as a symbol of that love and commitment. So now, by the power vested in me as marriage commissioner by the province of British Columbia, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and ask you to seal this joyous time with a kiss. Travis and Tanya
Martell.
Martell. Congratulations.
Honestly, I can't imagine a couple more ready, more right for this blessing, and I couldn't have ever imagined a bride more perfect for Travis. Thank you, Tanya, for bringing him and all of us such happiness.
I have looked up to you since the day that I was born. Not to take any credit from Mom and Dad, but you really did teach me everything that I know. Tink, you are not only my big sister, but my rock, my shoulder to cry on, my biggest fan, my biggest pain in the butt, my second closet, and the very best part of me. Tanya and Trav, make tomorrow better than today. And the next day better than that. So that decades from now, you won't have to settle for remembering the happiest day of your life, because you'll be living it.
Baby, when the shaking, you gotta know. When you got a good thing, you know you keep on bringing out the best in me. And I need you now even more than the air I breathe.
Day.